And today, General Norman Schwarzkopf revealed that finishing the Republican Guards in Iraq was as much a mission as liberating Kuwait.
If I'm to accomplish the mission that I was given, and that's to make sure that the Republican Guard is rendered incapable of conducting the type of heinous act that they've conducted so often in the past, what has to be done is these forces continue to attack across here and put the Republican Guard out of business.
In an extraordinary briefing that gave the world, including Saddam, the first look at how the Iraqi army had been routed, Schwarzkopf crowed about U.S. forces like the 101st Airborne landing deep in Iraq and how he could have taken Baghdad.
Ladies and gentlemen, when we were here, we were 150 miles away from Baghdad, and there was nobody between us and Baghdad. If it had been our intention to take Iraq, if it had been our intention to destroy the country, if it had been our intention to overrun the country, we could have done it unopposed, for all intents and purposes, from this position at that time.
The victory is almost complete. One senior Pentagon source predicted the fighting could end tomorrow. Officials said the American losses are remarkably light. At day's end, 23 Americans had died in the air war, 28 in ground combat, 28 from a Scud missile attack, including two women, for a total of 79 dead and 53 missing or captured. And the fighting continues. Two American divisions have trapped two Republican Guard units near Basra, Iraq. And an Allied force of 80,000 is closing in on the last three Guard units, which are also trying to flee.
Where we are today is we now have a solid wall across the north of the 18th Airborne Corps, consisting of the units shown right here, attacking straight to the east. We have a solid wall here again of the 7th Corps, also attacking straight to the east. The forces that they are fighting right now are the forces of the Republican Guard.
One Pentagon officer said the oily fires set by Iraqis had backfired on them. Thermal gun sights on U.S. tanks worked flawlessly, but the hazy, oily skies blinded the Iraqi tank crews.
We've had several anecdotal reports today of enemy who were saying to us that they couldn't see anything through their sights, and all of a sudden their tank exploded when their tank was hit by our sight.
In that two-day running tank battle, military leaders report that while most of Iraq's tanks have been put out of action, not one American tank has been destroyed. And for the first time today, General Schwarzkopf reported that thousands of Iraqis had deserted and many had been killed. Classified estimates put the losses at 80,000.
There was a very, very large number of dead in these units, a very, very large number of dead. We even found them when we went into the units ourselves and found them in the trench lines. There were very heavy desertions. At one point, we had reports of desertion rates of more than 30% of the units that were along the front here.
Well, Tom, for all intents and purposes, this war is over. In the last 4 hours, most of the information in that report has changed so dramatically. The senior Pentagon official said there is only one Iraqi division left. That is the Hammurabi division, and it is running for Iran. And in daylight hours, there will be clear skies, and it may not make it. Tom?